Hey guys, welcome to another MicroTech tutorial. I'm back with another video covering HTML5. And this time I'm going to be covering how to make an HTML5 video player. The last one I covered audio player, so let's get started. So the first thing you need to note is that just like an HTML5 audio player, it needs to be in different formats for certain browsers. So if I go ahead real quick, I have a video file right here. This is the directory where I will keep all my files. As you can see, I have video.mp4. The first thing I want to do is go ahead and make my index file. So if I go to open up Notepad++, I'm going to go ahead and save it to my directory, xampht.docs. And I'm just going to call this index.html. Go ahead and refresh. We are good to go. So the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and set out the layout. So HTML head title my video player title. Then we're going to go ahead and add that. Then go ahead and type the video tag src equals video.mp4 because then end video tag. Then go ahead and refresh. You will see this video player. Great. There's no way to start it though, and it's way too huge. So what do? So you want to go ahead and type. Go ahead and type the following code. So let's just make this better. So let's make this full screen so you can see the code better. So you want to type. Go ahead and type something that lets you add a better width and height. So width equals 640. And then the height will be 360, very similar to YouTube dimensions. So if I go ahead and save that, go over here, refresh, you see the video page is smaller. So if I go ahead and make this bigger, you need to add some controls. Controls equal controls. Save that. Refresh. Then it adds some control. You can style this with CSS and JavaScript, but I'm not going to show that in this video. So we added some controls. We added change the width, the height. But what if you want to add something else, like another source? Currently, we have video.mp4. But if let's just move this to a new line. So that you want to go ahead and make a new line. So if I do source src equals that. And refresh, save that, refresh. You should still get a video that is playing. So we need to do this for AUG as well as WebM because not all browsers will support it. So let's change this to .AUG and change this one to .WebM. Well, how do we convert the file? That's really easy. If you use Miro Video Converter, you can go ahead and just drag this video. So I'm just gonna drag video. And go ahead and hit convert. There are different formats. I need .3R. No. Do I need that one? Nope. So I don't need to create that. So as you can see, there's formats. You can do WebM. So I can go ahead and delete this file because I didn't need that format. WebM and AUG is what we need. So WebM and AUG. Let's just convert this real quick. Convert. It'll say starting. And just give it a second. And then there's also AUG. But the main three formats will be in the description, so you can remember. There's also an online video converter. All the links you need will be in the description. So if I go ahead and save this and go ahead and go to my video player. As you can see, it is available still. Good. And it'll work in multiple browsers. So, what if they don't have Flash? So, what if you aren't in a Flash-supported browser? You'll need to embed another version of this for those users that aren't in Flash. That only have Flash, but they don't have HTML5. So, here you have my video. So, I can go ahead and hit the share button. It'll open up this, hit embed. Just upload the video to YouTube, and then I can go ahead and paste it in there. And if I go ahead and refresh, it ignores it because it's not a valid HTML5 tag because it's within the video player, but the video tag itself is ignored for non-HTML5 browsers, therefore the iframe will show, and that's the case. So that's how you go ahead and do that. So last thing I want to do is show you the poster. So custom thumbnails, I'm just going to go ahead and put one. And you can actually do that with this video player. Sorry, I got interrupted. I want to just type poster equals then the link. So poster dot whatever this is. So I believe this is a PNG. So I'm going to put poster dot PNG. Go ahead and hit save. Let's go back to Chrome. Refresh, and as you can see, you have this nice custom thumbnail. Woo! That looks cool. Okay, so that's how you upload a video to your web server. And let's just say you wanted to put this on your website just to upload these files, whatever files you have. So in this case, I have just two formats, WebM, the MP4, and the poster and the index file. Go ahead and upload those. And you are good to go. You have a nice video player. You can also add other tags such as autoplay. Autoplay. I'll go ahead and save that. Visit this right here.
Welcome back
to there we go. And we are good to go. You can also obviously change the width and height, so you can basically do that. You can also loop it by typing loop equals loop. And then you have some great controls like that. But I'm going to remove the loop and the autoplay because I don't really need that. So that's how you basically make a simple HTML5 audio player. Subscribe for more videos if you found this helpful, and check out the rest of the show. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.